So Ecamm just dropped version 4 and it's the biggest update I've ever seen them do. And in this video, I want to highlight not only the new features, but explain how and why the whole app is evolving. And don't be tempted to just jump to the features that you recognize, because some of these are game changers and you may not have ever heard of them. So why the huge update? Well, I believe it's in response to a changing audience. You see, I used to refer to Ecamm back in the day as a tool for live streaming or doing Facebook Lives, but now a big proportion of Ecamm's customer base aren't even live streaming. So what are they using it for? Firstly, they're using it to record, but without going live. Maybe podcasts, YouTube videos, interviews, tutorials for online courses, Instagram videos, TikTok videos, things like that, using all of the powerful features here in Ecamm, but not necessarily going live with it. Secondly, another huge audience are purely using Ecamm to level up their Zoom meetings or MS Teams or wherever they're going. Taking the branding, taking the way that we can do slick presentations and things in here, and simply use this as a virtual camera into those other platforms. And in response to this shift in audience, Ecamm have changed the whole navigation to make it more intuitive. Shall we take a look? Now, this is obviously going to be an overview video showing you the highlights, but I'll point you to our full playlist at the end that will individually take you through all of these features in more detail. So here are the biggest changes that you need to understand. In the previous version of Ecamm, the navigation is all down here in the bottom right corner where you select a destination or choose to record only. Now in the new version, it's gone. Instead of heading down there to the different destinations to plow through, you now just go up here and right at the top you say, do I want to stream, record, or use the virtual camera? And notice that with stream unselected at the minute, I've got a record button down here. When I turn stream on, I get this new button down here. Now, I reckon you should always keep this record turned on. You don't ever want to do a live stream that you're not recording. And there's no reason why you wouldn't want to have the virtual cam switched on all the time as well. So really, you're choosing whether to live stream or not. So as we're selected for streaming, why don't we jump into this one first? It's one of the biggest updates. For the first time, you can now stream to up to 10 destinations all at the same time without needing to use an additional app like Restream. This is amazing. Head into the preferences area here and the destinations tab to add all your potential destinations in advance. A very simple tool would just walk you through this, helping you add them in. As you can see here, I've added as many as I can think of, but by putting them here in advance, it means that when I click on new, and I decide I want to schedule, I can now list down all of those destinations that I've already entered, and it becomes a simple case of clicking one or multiple of these to create this multi-stream. I enter a title and a description. I select the visibility, so this is for YouTube in this case. We want it to be public. Additional information that I can add in for all these different sites. I can schedule it down here with this nice calendar view. I can add an image in, and when I hit schedule, and here I've now got an upcoming live tomorrow, which we put in our thumbnail title and the description will be there. And I can head over to any of these posts by just clicking here, go to the event, or copy the event URL. So if I want now to be able to send this out to my email list and invite people across, I can say copy the watch page URL. And let's just paste it in here to show you. This is the link you're sending them to, and they'll have a button that says to notify them. If you want to update all these locations at once, you can click on the pencil and change them around in here. If you want to go in individually and change them around, I can go in and edit in YouTube Studio, or it will do the same for Facebook. And I can just put something specific in there that maybe is just relevant to that destination. Really powerful. If I decide I want to remove one of these destinations, I can just click on it from here and remove it from the event, and it's now not going to go to that, and it will delete out the notification. I love this. I'm actually going to delete all of them from here. I think I'm right in saying, yes, LinkedIn doesn't work from here. You'd have to go to it manually. And so let's just do that because we don't want people over on LinkedIn wondering what's happening tomorrow. A delete event. How good is that? And as you schedule multiple events, they'll all appear in a little list down there. So if like me in the middle of an academy, you've got daily lives going out, you'll be able to see them all individually. You can edit them all from within this control panel. Fantastic. Then I don't know if you spotted there, but when we just looked at those destinations, they've added in here destinations for Amazon Live and for Instagram Live. So all we need to be able to drop in is the stream key for Amazon. And there's even a tutorial there to tell you how to walk through and set all that up. This update also allows you to see the live view count, add comments, and see the new followers that are joining you on that Amazon Live stream. And as I mentioned, Instagram are now rolling out the ability to live stream from a desktop computer, and Ecamm are on the ball with that, and they've put a destination in there too. I just haven't got access yet, so I can't do a demonstration for you. Aww. So that's some exciting streaming updates. What else have they done? Well, if you're an interviewer, here's a few exciting updates. First, you can now have up to 10 guests on the broadcast with you, which sounds like a total nightmare to me, but I know some of you want this. I guess if you've got a panel on there or something, you can now do it. Another update, you can now split not only your audio feeds, but your camera feeds too, although you are going to need to have an Apple Silicon Mac, an M1 or an M2. This means that when you record an interview, at the end, you'll have the mix plus a separate video and audio file for you and each of your guests. This is a big deal if you or an editor want to be able to mix that afterwards. You've got multiple guests and you don't really notice on the live, but they're just slightly off. Well, afterwards, you'll be able to mix and balance that or change who's on camera at what point. Some of you are going to be just going crazy over this one. And it's not only for interviewing and having those guest feeds coming in. If you use multiple cameras, you'll now get a clean feedback from two cameras that are attached to your computer, plus the broadcast. So I've done it in the past where we've had two cameras working and I've used the main feed as a screen recording. So in effect, I've got two camera angles plus a screen share. This now allows me to record tutorial videos that I can edit and mix after. And if your cameras can handle it, this can be done in 4K. Now, talking of multiple cameras, some of you have been dreaming of this for years. Ecamm have now given us a lovely camera switcher window. It's a new icon at the top here. And when I click on it, I can get my different cameras. I've got two cameras attached here. This is offering my iPad. I can remove that from the switcher. And look, I can increase the size of these. I can increase the shape of it. And if I want to take that even bigger, I can say show source in a separate window. And now I get these two floating windows that potentially with other monitors, I could have these things full size. That's gonna be massive for some of you. I know I've spoken to folk before that are trying to set up church streams or conference setups, and you need to be able to have the ability to see these cameras in detail and know which camera you're switching to. Well, now you've got it. And it isn't just seeing the cameras as themselves. Like I've got Camlink 4K, Camlink 4K 2. I can actually create placeholders in here and call it camera A, camera B. I can keep going with as many of these as I want. And while at first this might not obviously seem a big deal, trust me, as you start to get used to this, it really is. And I think this is the way that we need to get used to adding cameras as overlays into our scenes. It now works very much like how adding a guest, I don't have to take John or Sarah or Jim. I can set up a scene with guest one, guest two, guest three. And then as they come in, I can allocate who I want to that different placeholder. And it's the same here now with the camera switcher. In the past, I've been super frustrated when I've made dozens of scenes and I've set it up with Camlink. And then maybe I've gone away, we've come back and I've plugged in another camera only to find that the camera that I wanted is now called Camlink 2. And I've got to go back through all those scenes and relink them. This way, I would now bring a camera source in and I would call it camera A. And then afterwards in my switcher, I can come back and I can choose which camera I want to be camera A. This would also be a big deal if you were setting up scenes in advance or maybe for somebody else and you don't have the cameras connected yet. You can now use these placeholders and then use the camera switcher to sort which camera's going to camera A, camera B, camera C. As I say, I think it's gonna be a great discipline when setting up scenes to be talking in terms of cameras A, B, and so on. And each of these lettered camera placeholders don't need to be a different camera. You can use the same camera, but change it. So camera A can be my front camera here. camera B could be this same one, and instead of actually me needing to go down to my camera effects tab, I can click up here, it opens the camera effects, and maybe I decide that camera B is just the black and white version of the color me. So all these changes I'm making over here, I haven't had to do beforehand. I've just simply chosen, is this camera A or is this camera B? And we've put multiple cameras in here. We haven't hit a limit yet. So someone's going to ask me, how many cameras can you add to this, or how many different scenarios can you do? We haven't found a limit yet. Let me know in the comments as and when you do. Now, this is all fun, but in a real world scenario of this, when Owen and I are on camera together, this is really useful. Let me demonstrate. Hello, Owen.
Hello.
We can set camera A to be this widescreen of both of us. We can then set camera B to be the same camera, but I can click my effects and I can zoom in down here. And let's go with Owen on this one. So Owen is now camera B. We can add camera C. We're going to select the same camera. But on this one, we're zooming in over to my side. So now when we select camera A, or we can go to camera B or camera C, we can tweak this a little bit. And certainly if we were bringing it in as an overlay, I think we'd probably put us into boxes. This is a big deal. And to be able to do this out of one camera, there are times when we want to be able to put comments on screen in the middle of us and have both of us sitting either side of it, or sharing the screen and us sitting up there. Ecamm is seeing this as three cameras that we're getting out of one. Yeah. Pretty cool. Thank you, Owen. I'll let you go. Now, the last big update that I want to draw your attention to is the new inbuilt bandwidth checker. You no longer need to go off to the website to see what your internet speed is before you go live. Ecamm's got it built in now. Come down to your preferences, click on stream, and down the bottom here, it will tell you we're still set for these three destinations. It's suggesting it's going to take 20 megs, and it did a speed test here to tell me that my connection is giving 664 at the moment. So understandably, we get a nice green tick. If you were on an internet connection that was less than 20.6, you would be getting a red mark on here that would be telling you you can't go streaming to this amount of destinations. And what I love with this, we can go to a speed checker site and it will tell us what our internet upload speed is. What it won't tell us is what is required. And notice how this changes on here. If I go for one destination, it brings it down to 6.9. If I change 1080 up to 4K, firstly, it's given me a warning to say that it's not gonna do the isolated video recording in 4K, that's okay. Notice though that it's taken me on here, 4K, one destination is now 17.7 meg. If I were to bring it down to 720, you can see that that's only taking 4 meg. So this is really informative to be able to help you if you're on those lower internet speeds. Making these changes here will make a big difference. And actually, if I just come back to 1080 here, which would be my default, notice how this changes, how it multiplies up every time we add a destination in. So while it's tempting to think we can go out to 10 destinations, you might be really pushing it on here for your internet, and it might make more sense for you to go to one destination and just point people over to it. Want to drop it down even more? Even the frame rate up here will make a difference to that internet requirement. Any point you can hit and do a speed test. And actually, it's not only in here. Every time that we want to create a new live, look, right at the bottom here, it says that the required speed in this case will be 15 because we've got 3 in. And notice that, look, in real time, as I'm changing this, that is going down, telling me, yes, you can go ahead, or it'll give me a red light to say no. Amazing.
Hey, that's pretty good.
Okay, so those are the big updates, but here are a few more to highlight so you don't miss them. I'll whiz over them quite quick. There's a digital blur and sepia effect. Camera effects now includes a digital blur that you can put over the front of this, and a sepia tone as well. Record only mode will now begin after a 3 second countdown, or you can turn it off if you prefer it the other way. When you've got a live scheduled and you're getting ready to go live, there's a mouse over hint on that go live button that indicates which destinations you're going to be going out to. And then similarly, there is a new status pop-up with individual view accounts and statuses for each of those destinations during your live. So if you're curious midway through the live, who's actually watching. It'll tell you how many are on Facebook, YouTube, LinkedIn, all your different destinations. And if you want to, there's also the ability to end one of the individual destinations partway through the stream. I can see a use for this where maybe you're going out publicly and also into a group that people pay to be in, and maybe you close off the public version at some point and say, right now, we're exclusively going into the membership group. Goodbye to you guys. And now you're just talking to your paying members, your VIP guys. I could really see a use for this. And a final one that excites me, if you're up to date with your Mac and you've got an iPhone, notice how when you bring your phone near your computer, it says, do you want to use the camera? This continuity camera feature is built in here. So literally you just click to start and it will wirelessly see your phone as a camera source. And the results are staggering. So there it is, your all new Ecamm Live. What do you think? Which of those features are you most excited about? Or maybe you already knew about them, you've been playing with them in beta. Tell me how you're getting on with it. I'm proper excited about these. I think we should say a big thank you to Ken, Glenn, and the entire Ecamm team for once again over-delivering with an awesome update. And as I said at the start, be sure to head over to our Ecamm tutorial playlist where I go into all of these features in way more detail. And if you really want to learn how to get the maximum out of Ecamm, please register for our next Ecamm Live Academy. Come and join us for the live bootcamp. Thanks as ever for your interest. Let us know if you've enjoyed us by giving us a nice thumbs up, and I'll see you in another video.